Okay, I am going to go to the shade called. Well, that was not the shade name. That was me trying to not burp. Yes, you're welcome. Honey buns. This is not handy because I have to put eyeshadow on my face. Why don't you go here then? Here. I should have closed the door. I should have closed the door. My lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And can I just say Happy King's Day, because the day I'm filming this is Tuesday the 27th of April. It's the birthday of our king Willem-Alexander, and today is King's Day. Yes, so technically I should be wearing orange, but I'm not. So yeah, there's that. But yeah, that's not why you clicked on this video now, is it? You clicked on this video because you want to see me create three looks and hear my thoughts on this one. One of the latest palettes from Glam Shop in Poland, which is the Camo palette. That's what it translates as, and I think it's just, if I would pronounce it, it's motto. I still don't really know what to do with the W though. Is it silent? Is it the motto? I don't know. I know one of you told me, but I forgot. So sorry about that. Yeah, the look that I have on my eyeballs right now is the last look of the video. Timestamps will be down in the description box, and I will also list the Glam Shop Poland playlist for you guys. And yeah, that's basically it. Let me tell you a little bit about this palette. It is one of the latest. They released two palettes not too long ago. This one and a purpley one. And I opted out on the purpley one. I actually don't really know why. But I ordered this one, and I also ordered the eye pencil that basically goes with the palette, which is a dark green, a dark forest green, I think you would call it. I have it in my waterline right now. Let me tell you a tiny bit about this palette. It contains 9 shades. You get 4 mattes and the rest are shimmers. The shade khaki is kind of your traditional shimmer, a little bit more foiled than the old school shimmers. And then there are 2 more duochrome shades in there, and then you get 2 very special gorgeously sparkly bits, shades. I don't know what they call them, but they are very, 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 very pretty. Let me also show you the swatches, or maybe you have already seen them, depending on how quickly I talk. The shimmers swatch beautifully. The mattes, though, not so much. When I swatch, I need to swatch on top of my arm because of the tattoos that I have in the inside of my arm. And if I forget to shave, or I just feel lazy and I don't want to shave, some shadows can just basically not stick on my arm. When shadows behave like that on my arm, I know that it is a shadow that can blend easily. And that is, in my book, a good thing. Yes, yes. If you want to know my overall thoughts on this palette and if I think it is worth it, make sure that you check the end of the video. There will be timestamps in the description box for all 3 looks and for the review part, if you just want to skip or, you know, bounce around a little bit. Yeah, before we go any further, did I say that at the end of the video I give you my thoughts? I did, right? It's confusing today. Yes, never mind. Before we go any further, grab a drink and a snack and put your feet up and enjoy, because here comes look number 1. Look 1. And I don't know what's happening with my brows. Apparently we are in caterpillar mode. And on camera they still look red. Outside and in the mirror they look fine. I don't know, maybe they need to settle down a bit. I have no idea. I am going to use the Sigma eye base for today's video, because I want to. That's the only reason. Is this a sharpener? Oh really? Huh. Did you know that there's also a sharpener on the bottom of the Sigma stick? I did not know, but we learned something today, right? Oh yes, you can see I just swatched the palette as well for the close-ups. I am, however, going to start with a shade called Pochisk. This one? I am not sure though. Because as per usual, I forgot to kinda check how the shades should be pronounced. But I am going to start with that one on a somewhat fluffier brush, I think. Let's see what it does with a synthetic brush, because very powdery. But that is, or very kick-up-y, that is the nature of the shade and the nature of the brush. So let's tap it on a base that is still a bit sticky, because I think, I don't know, I think that these shadows need that.
a nice shade.
But I'm basing this just on how they swatched. Nice. I kind of built it up a little bit. Because I wanted to. That is the only reason. Let's grab different brush. Still for the same shade though. I'm going to put it low, but I am going to follow my lid up for the angle. And if it is too far down, I can always clean it up when I do my base. I kind of want to leave it like this with a little bit of depth. So I'm going to go to a shade darker, which is the shade Dovotchka. Dovotchka. There's a thingy on the second O. This one. Tap off brush. Because the shadows are pretty kick-uppy. Not that I mind that, but... And again, this is a pretty fluffy brush that I'm using, and I'm doing that for a reason. So I don't have to blend as much in the first layer. Then I'm going to go to the shimmers. I think that's the plan right now. Okay, okay. I am going to go to the shade called... Well, that was not the shade name. That was me trying to not burp. Yes, you're welcome. I am going to go to the shade Shergovi. That one. And it looks deceptively green in the pen. But when I swatch it, I'm very curious to see what this does on my eye. Because when I swatched it, it went all orangey on me. I'm going to use it dry first. Very, very unique. Let's spray it for the other eye and see what happens. It's a bit of a flakier formula to pick up with the brush though. And I picked up on the brush. I sprayed the brush. Okay, I don't know. It's almost easier to put on my eye if it's dry. But that's with the brush I'm using now. It could be the brush. Very, very pretty. I do feel like I want to kind of keep building it up, if that makes sense. But it's just the nature of the shade, because it has some, I don't know, somewhat of an almost a skin-like tint to it, if that makes any sense at all. I kind of feel like it is sheer on my eyes, but it's not. Very pretty. And then I'm going to go to the shade called Voskovi. That one. It's going to go in the inner eye part area. Dry as well. Small brush. Let's see what it does then. Maybe the brush was too big. Oh yeah, that's better. Fun. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the shade called khaki. That one. Or cakey, as we would say it. It's going to go underneath my eye. And also kind of a little bit lower. It's a very smooth formula, this. Also a little bit here in the outer corner. Because then it all, I don't know, matches better. This is it so far. I'm going to finish everything off. Think about a pencil. I don't know. Maybe an orangey or a red. Maybe even a yellowy or a shorter. Maybe even a teal. No. I'm going to think about a pencil. Finish off the rest of the face. And then I will be back to show you the completed look. I really like how this all came together. Yes, let me tell you about the falsies. These are the Shop Miss A 3D Foaming Lashes in Nora. And the lippy is a Catrice Plumping Lip Liner in the shade Polite Rebellion. Yes, Polite Rebellion, wow. And then a Juvia's Place lippy in the shade Invoke, which is an orangey. Yes, oh yeah, the eye pencil I ended up choosing is the NYX Epic Wear Liner Stick in the shade Orange Zest. And the rest of the makeup will be listed down below in the description box. And yeah, this was it. I thought I wanted to say something else, but I forgot. But oh yeah, that's what I forgot. My highlighter, well, I actually have two on because I put on the Ray Rider from Kaleidos. But I thought, let's be funky and also put this shade on top. So I actually did that. So this shade that I have in the inner corner is also as a highlighter. I think it's pretty. Yes, this was look number one. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number two. I have already primed my eyes. And I'm going to start with the shade called Caliber. I am going to use this maybe as a one color crease as well. I'm just tapping it on and then lightly blending it to basically set my eyeshadow primer. Okay, then I'm going to go to a slightly bigger brush without any product. Still the same color, but I'm going to go to a smaller and denser brush. And I'm going to build it up. I'm just going to pick up the kick up in the pan. Okay, switching brushes again. Just make sure that the blend on the edges is good. Okay, I'm going to go to the shade called Sluts Bowie. I don't know, but there's a thingamajiggy on the Z, so I don't exactly know how to pronounce it. It's going to deepen up the crease a bit. I'm going to stamp that brown a little bit more on the outer part of my eye, just to give it definition a little bit for what I am planning to do. I don't know if my plan will work, that's why I didn't mention it. Okay, with this brush I'm going to go back to the first shade that I use and I'm going to put it on my lid. Okay, a little bit more of that brown. I am going to use the shimmer called Khaki, but I'm going to use it with the brush I just used, so very... really looking like Auntie Vester. Look, like I haven't slept in weeks, which is not true. So I'm going to use this shade, but not specifically as a shimmer. I am going to use the shine though. So I'm grabbing it with the brush I just used. I'm just going to dust it over my lid. So basically create more of a satin. And this is a very, very nice way of making a shimmer less intense. If you want... I don't know, an everyday kind of thing, but you still want a little bit of a sparkle. Now, maybe this is not everyday for a lot of people or work appropriate, but you can do this with any color. I'm going to go back to that brown and I'm kind of going to pack it on a little bit in the outer corner. It's all good. Okay. Next, I am going to go to the center shade. The shade Motto. This is such a gorgeous shade. I'm going to swatch it for you because it just needs to be appreciated. So I can put this all over the eye and make a very, very gorgeous, shiny eye. That was not really the look I was going for today though. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to pick out an eye pencil. It can take a while. Fortunately, I can cut things out and speed things up.
This has potential. Yes, it's more of the base shape, but that's okay. No, I don't think that I have the color I'm looking for. Which is kind of a shame.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
I don't know what kind of pencil I want. I am, however, going to grab my glitter primer if I know where I left it. Oh, here, in front of me, of course, where it always is. I'm going to put it on the back of my hand. Then I'm going to grab a small brush. I'm going to stamp the glitter primer on my lower lid. Around the tear duct and in the inner corner. I'm going to go to the shade Motto, the center shade that I just showed you. Very, very shiny and sparkly, isn't it? Okay. Basically going to blend it a little, as if I were to do, I do this sometimes with neons and a neutral look. And you know what, let's just go for it. I don't usually do this, so I'm just going to put it here. To have a sparkly bottom today. It's very chunky though, this. It reminds me of sometimes when you see people gold leafing, using gold leaf, you know. That's what it reminds me of. Now for eye pencil. I think I'm going to go for this one, which is a very dark... Is it an army green or an olivey green? Something like that. But I think that will kind of tie everything together, and then I can darken up my lashes as well a little. You know what? Let's for funsies. I never do this actually. Also tight line with this pencil. A little bit more on the inner eye part area. So I'm just tapping on a little bit of glitter primer that I still have. And these flakes are very soft. It looks like glitter, but it's not. This is a formula that looks like glitter, but again, it is not, and I like it a lot. Let's blend it a bit. I'm also going to grab a little bit of that shimmer shade that I had, khaki, to just make sure that the transition isn't too harsh. So basically, we're going from day to night again. And if you want it less shiny, what you could also do is put a little bit of a matte shade on top of it. But I think this is fun. It's not something that I do often. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean everything up, put on the base, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. I really like how this turned out. Eye pencil. Did I mention the eye pencil? I don't remember. Where did I put it? Eye pencil is from Kiko Milano in the shade 10, which is a very dark, what is it, olive-y, shimmery green? I don't know. Could be a foresty olive. I have no idea. Falsies are from Primark in the style Paris, if I can find the box that would be handy. Yes, Paris. And then a lippy is also from Glam Shop Poland. It is one of their lip liners in Jasni Karamelek. I think I pronounced that correct. Karamelek. It's one or the other. Maybe I'm trying to pronounce it the Russian way. I don't know. And then the lippy is the shade Boskoptova, also from Glam Shop. And then you kind of get this. Yes. This, that's what I wanted to say. I really do like it. Oh yes, and I changed out the septum piercing to kind of match a little bit. Fun times, fun times. Yes, this was look number 2 with this palette. Let me know down below what you think of it. Let's get ready for look number 3. Happy King's Day. It's King's Day here in the Netherlands. So yeah, the birthday of our King William Alexander. Or as we say in Dutch, Willem Alexander. Yes, that's what he is called in Dutch. I am going to... Well, I kind of wanted to do a brown look today. Yeah, I know. Who am I? I'm going to start with the shade Sluch... I don't know. The brown. It's not really that early anymore, but it's too early for me to try and pronounce the name. Today, at least. So first I'm going to map out the shape. And this line is going to be my outer edge. Just going to work it in from the outer corner in. Base is still sticky. And I can see that because now I use this shade without layering it. And it's way more vibrant. So if you want this a little bit more toned down, just set your base first. But it does blend out beautifully. Oh yes, my washing machine is on and unfortunately my door cannot close when it is on. And it is in centrifugal mode, so that is what you're hearing. I don't even know if you can hear it, but if you hear something, it's probably that. Clean brush. Okay, so this is a color that you can blend away, which I kind of thought it would be. And I see that I'm blending it away. That's okay though, because I can always put it back. And that's what I'm going to do now. Okay. I'm going to go to a smaller brush. I want the outer corner a little bit more intense, a little bit darker, and I want that on my lid as well. That's it for the mat. I have been blending for what? 2 minutes? 3? This is the kind of eye look that I like. For everyday wear, you know? Okay, I am going to go next to the shade Corsari, I think. Which is going to be Fallout City. You know what? I'm just going to spray. And I know that they don't need it shimmer-wise. But I'm going to spray Fallout-wise. I have a brush that is more open, so... Let's see what it does. It's such a pretty shade. I actually don't really like it sprayed, I think. I don't know, it sticks to the brush too much, almost. But it's just a gorgeous... I don't even know what kind of color it is, but it's so, so pretty. And it's also a flaky formula, which I can see. Yes. It's the same type of shade as the shade Motto, the center shade. I'm going to grab that brown matte again. I'm just going to make sure that the crease is nice and blended. So the pencil I have is one from Essence, and I love the color and I like the formula, but I don't know, it almost seems like it has dried out on me a bit. And I don't, this one does not have one of those sharpeners on the bottom. Ah, there it is. So usually I kind of break a piece off, you know, and then use it. Okay, let's get a small pencil, a little bit of glitter primer, and put that same shade on my bottom lid as well. So I'm just stamping it on, the glitter primer I mean, and then go into that browny shimmery shade and stamp it over. I'm going to go to this shade, which I have been using as my inner corner highlight throughout the entire video. I'll probably use it as a face highlighter again today. Oh yeah, this is nice. This I like. I like this a lot. So basically this is it. And I have been, I don't know, including the cat filming for 12 minutes, but that parts have been cut out. So what did it take me? I don't know, 5, 7? It is a quick eye look, which is kind of nice sometimes, you know. I'm going to finish everything off and then I will be back and yeah, give you my my opinion on the palette. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. As you can see, I changed my pencil. I completely forgot that I also had ordered the pencil that goes with this palette. So that's the pencil that I wanted to try, so I could kind of give you my thoughts on it as well. I will in just a second, but that's the pencil. The falsies are from Essence, the Likeables Lashes in the style Unique. Lippy is a ColourPop Lippy Pencil in BFF3 combined with the Black Moon Cosmetics Liquid Lipstick Insider. Let me give you my thoughts on this palette. Yeah, I like it. I like the color story a lot. I think that the shimmers are gorgeous. I like the fact that there are different finishes in here. And the shimmers are very, very easy to work with. You can use them dry, you can spray them, you can use them with a glitter primer if you want to as well. I did not really have any favorite brushes that I wanted to use them with. The only thing though, the only side note that I have for the two very special shades that are in here, these two, they have flakes in them. And I feel that, especially today with the shade that I used here, that the brush I used picked up the flakes beautifully. But when I sprayed it, I felt like they almost wanted to stick to the bristles, because the brush I use, I don't even know where I have it. But anyway, the brush that I use is open. So the flakes kind of twisted themselves around the fibers, I almost feel. So honestly, I prefer this with a dry brush or a different brush and then spray. But yeah, they went on my eye beautifully. I did want to build it up a tiny bit, but that is also, I think, the nature of the brush that I used. They are just, they're gorgeous. They have a special name for them, but I forgot. Then this shade here, I have used as an inner corner throughout the entire video, and it gives it a whole, it almost gives it some class. Maybe that's a little bit different, but when you put this one away, it is a whole different palette. And this one gives it a little bit of a, I don't know, classiness. I don't know why I feel that way. I just do. It's probably the color. Yeah, it's also very gorgeous as a highlight, at least on my olive complexion. Yes, maybe that's helpful. And then this shade here, it's just so deceptive, because when you look at it, you think, oh, it's a green. I don't know if I can show you the shift though. Let's see if I can. I don't even think so. Let me swatch it again then, because it is a green, but it also has a, it reminds me, you know what it reminds me of? That is, it reminds me of that special shade that I have from 5050 Makeup. Although this one is more foiled than this one, but it's the same principle. This one doesn't have the hot pink that's in that shade, but it is very, very similar. Maybe that's helpful to you as well. It's not as foiled, and I think I already said that. But I really like that they put this one in there as well, because it gives it another dimension. It just, this palette just has some surprises in it that takes it up a notch. Now, those were the shimmers. The mattes, I have thoughts on the mattes. They did not swatch well. They were very, I want to say powdery, but that's, they are powdery, but in a good way. They're not really dry. They are very easy to blend. You can layer them as well. However, I feel that if you want to get a lot of pigmentation, like I did today with this brown shade, you need to use them as a first layer on top of a sticky base. So you can layer them, but I do feel that the more you layer these, the softer they become, which can be a good thing. But remember that if you want a very in-your-face color scheme, make sure that where you place it, it's the only shadow, and then basically blend them into each other a little bit, if that makes any sense at all. So for instance, if I, and the way that I used this shade today, I packed it on and then blended it up. Now if I want this shade prominent to deepen up, but I for instance also want this shade, I start usually with this shade a little bit higher, because I know that in the crease and the outer corner I want to put a different shade. Then I keep the first shade a little bit higher, so I have space to basically put the pigmentation here, and then that I can blend it there. Does that make any sense at all? I do hope so. You can layer these, you can layer all these shades on top of each other, but they get softer as you layer them. So because there is a, it, they are a little bit more, again with the powderiness, they are not as sticky. Some mattes that I have kind of a sticky binder in them, which makes them great to layer, but more difficult to blend out. These mattes are very easy to blend out, and they layer, but they layer softly. Does that make any sense? I hope so. If you have watched the looks, you can maybe see what I mean. What I like most about this palette, I think, is that you can be very, very quick. So the look that I have today, truly the eye look without the falsies, took, I don't know, what was it, 10 minutes? Both eyes? Which is so, so quick. So, and it does not look it, you know? I like looks like that. I like being able to create a very elaborate look if I want to, if I have the time and I really want to do that. But I also love that I have palettes here that I can just do a very quick look, that I can also spruce up a little bit if I want to, and I feel like I can do it with this. This could be a very nice everyday green palette for a lot of people. If you are a little bit scared of greens but want to venture into greens, I think this can be a great one to start with, because you have that brown that is very, very pretty brown in my opinion, but still very easy to work with. You can blend it out, you can pack it on and blend it out, you can, you know, layer it on top of each other, on itself, and you can combine it with the other mattes. But because these greens are a little bit more muted, it is, I think, for a lot of people a safe way to start into greens. And if you want to spruce it up, you can go to more greens, but yeah, you can use this or even this one. And I know I did not use it all over the lid, but there was a reason for it that I did not want to use it all over the lid, because I know that most people will use this all over the lid, and I wanted to give you options. You can go elaborate, you can go very simple every day, you can go soft, you can go ham if you want to. Bottom line, do I think that this palette is worth it? Yes. So far, everything that I have tried from Glam Shop did not disappoint. That's it for today's video. Let me know if you have this palette. Let me know if you've ever tried Glam Shop. Do you have a favorite look? Do you have a favorite palette? Let me know down below in the comment section. So yeah, oh yeah, I almost forgot the pencil, didn't I? When I put this in my waterline, the first thing I said was, wow, this was so, so easy. Yeah, and color, instantaneous color. So looking at how it is on my waterline, I think that it will stay for a very, very long time as well. And if it doesn't stay for a long time, I will update you in the comment section, in a pinned comment. Yes, now that is going to be it. I am going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And yeah guys, thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you tomorrow for a new Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. Bye guys.